Beach, show number 74. Take one in color.
I know why you came back here. You wanted to find out what was going to happen on Sesame Street today, huh? And you thought I could tell you. Well, I can give you a couple of hints, maybe. Maybe Big Bird will show up. Maybe Susan will be around here. Maybe somebody... You never know. You really never know, but... But you can tell by that noise what that is. That's Big Bird. Hello, Big Bird.
Oh, hi, Gordon.
What are you doing?
Well, I'm looking at this really interesting book, and I'm trying to read it.
Oh, you having a little trouble?
Well, I can't read too good yet. I'm just learning, but it sure is interesting what I can read. It's about magic.
Magic?
Mm.
Well, let me give you a hand here. Let me see what it is.
See?
Hey, it is interesting. Here's one. It says how to make giant letters appear as if by magic.
Yes. I don't really believe this stuff, you know, but it looks good.
Okay, wait a minute, Big Bird. Let me tell you what it says. Here's how you do it. It says you... Hold up three fingers, pat your head, look for something colored red, press your nose and twist your ear, and let a giant R appear.
Isn't that
funny? How about
funny?
That? That's pretty wild. I guess an R is supposed to come up, huh?
Yes.
I don't think I'd go along with that, though. It doesn't seem like it.
Gordon? Hmm?
Yeah?
What if we tried it?
Oh, come on, Big Bird. That really wouldn't work. You wouldn't get a giant R.
Wait a minute. It might be fun to try it.
Well, you got a point there. Okay, we'll try anything once. Let's see what happens. Wait a minute. Hold up three fingers. Mm-hmm. One, two, three. Right?
It's three.
Pat your head. Look for something colored red. See anything colored red around here?
Wait a minute. My mouth. Look, my mouth is red inside.
Inside. That's right. It's red. Yeah. Oh, easy. Close it. Good. Press your nose and twist your ear and let a giant R appear. Wow. What?
Gordon!
Big Bird!
It worked! Look! That's an R!
You're right. It's really an R.
That's an R word to say it's really an R.
Well, I know that's an R word, but this is a big R, and it's right here in the middle of our street.
Well, it's magic. Is it real?
Well, I don't know. It's in the road. I think we're going to have to move it. Remove it. I guess we'll have to... Well, why don't you get one side?
Okay.
And I'll grab the other side, and let's see if we can remove it. Remove is an R word. Wow, look at,
it's really heavy, too.
It really is. Yeah, well...
It's right in the way.
It really is. I guess I'll have to reread the book.
Oh.
And see if it says anything about removing the letter R.
Oh, sure, Gordon. If it says how to get it here, it'll probably tell you how to get it away from here.
It probably will. It says how to remove rutabagas. Says how to remove rhinoceri, and they're all R words. It says how to remove almost everything, but it doesn't say how to. It says how to remove robins, but I wouldn't do that because.
Oh no, I like them.
I know you like them. Renaissance renegades and everything, but nothing about rutabagas, rhesus monkeys, not the letter R.
Well, it's right in the way.
Now, what are we going to do? We have a giant R right here in the middle of the sidewalk.
Wait a minute, Gordon. We could use it to tell stories.
How?
Oh, like this?
Today, I'm going to tell you about the letter R. R is for rooster. And rubber. And rake. It's also for river. And make no mistake, it's even for rowboat. And rocks. And for rain. That causes the robber to go down the drain. Very well. What letter have we learned about today?
R.
Good heavens, a talking dog.
Can you name this letter? If you said R, you were correct. Let's say R together now. Ready? R! Fine. Now, here's something that starts with the letter R. Do you know what this is? Here, let me help you to guess. Yes, it's a radio. That's a nice tune. My ship has sails that are...
R. Rabbit.
R.
Well, Big Bird, this R is a real riddle.
I don't really know what we're going to do with it. It's so big.
Yeah, it's beyond reason. I can't figure it out, Big Bird.
Hey, you guys, what are you doing with this great big letter R right in front of the desk?
Oh, Susan, it's just wonderful in a way. It's magic the way it came here.
Magic?
Oh, yeah. You see, Big Bird, Susan, he had this book.
See this book?
And it's a magic book. And what we did, we looked in there and we did this magic thing. We said, you pat your head 3 times and you do something, you scratch your neck or something, and then whoosh, up comes this big magic giant letter R.
You guys are kidding.
But it won't go away.
That's the whole point.
It
can't be moved. It won't be budged. No.
You can't move it?
Won't work. No. Mm-hmm.
Well, let's find a spell to move it since you brought a spell.
Well, we looked in that book.
There's nothing there. It won't remove it.
Can't even remove a Rumpelstiltskin.
Oh, there isn't one to remove it. Oh, here's one that says we can change it into something else.
Change it into what else?
Oh, it doesn't say what else.
Uh-oh.
Oh, we can change it into something that starts with that letter. So, something that starts with R.
Well, it's worth a try. Go ahead and read it off.
Let's see. It says you have to point to the ground and then point to a star. Change into something that starts with R. Let's see. Point to the ground. Point to a star. Change into something that starts with an R.
Hey, the R is gone, but it's pouring down rain. Come on. Oh, you're already gone. Get away from me.
Well, honey, we got the other thing that started with R.
Yeah.
We got the rain. Now, how do we get rid of that?
I don't know. Read the book or something. Maybe there's another thing in there.
Oh, it says we can get something that rhymes with what we have. That means we can get something that rhymes with rain. If I say, let the sun come out and shine again, give us something that rhymes with rain.
Oh, come on.
It stopped raining. Hey, there's the something that rhymes with rain. A plane. I'm glad it stopped raining, because I wanted to go read a story.
Oh, yeah. Listen, why don't you give me that book, this magic thing, because I'm going to give it back to Big Bird.
Oh, don't give it back to him. Why don't you hide it or something?
I don't know. Why don't you go read that story?
Okay,
I'll just run down here. I'll see you later.
See you. today's story is called Maybe a Monster. I think I'll make a trap. Wonder what I'll catch. See him building the monster trap? Maybe a monster. I'd better go build a cage. It might be enormous. I'd better make a big cage. Maybe it will have two heads. I'd better make a place for them. What if it shoots fire out of his nose? I'd better cut holes for the fire to come out. What if it has an enormous tail? I'd better make tail space. Maybe it will have big wings. I'd better make wing space. Now, I'll go get the monster. What if he's mean? I better get protected. I'll take my slingshot. I'd better take my water pistol to put out the fire. I'll wear my football stuff. What if he won't come with me? I better take some rope. Now I'm ready. Well, look what I caught. He caught a little bunny rabbit. What's that? It's a rabbit cage, stupid. See how big the monster cage is for the little bunny rabbit? But anyway, he caught his monster and it just turned out to be a rabbit. You know what? I haven't seen Ernie and Bert around today. I wonder what they're up to now.
Hey, Ernie. Hey, what's hey, that?
Oh, that's a toaster, Bert.
No, you dummy. What, I mean, what is that on the plate there?
Oh, that's homemade bread. See, I'm going to make us some toast.
It looks good.
Uh-oh. Something's wrong here.
Ernie.
There's something wrong with your side of the toaster, Bert.
Ernie, there is something wrong with your head, ding-a-ling. Look, you've gone and sliced one piece of bread too thick. See?
Oh, of course I see. Don't you think I can see that one of these slices is thicker than the other? Whoa.
Look, now, Ernie, try that slice there, the thin one in your hand. Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah, that one.
Okay, well, let's see. Hey, it worked. You did it, Bert. You fixed it. Hey, that's great. Here we go. All righty. Except for one thing. Now, there's something wrong with my side of the toaster.
What's happening, man?
I don't know.
What's that?
I don't know.
Looks like a fish hook.
It's not a fish hook. It's a J.
A what?
The letter J. Like to hear a story about the letter J, boys?
Yes.
Once upon a time, a guy named Joe noticed a June bug on his toe. Put it in a jar and started to go. But here come the judge and said, no, no, no. So Joe said why and started to jump and dance a jig on an old tree stump. Then jogged along to the city dump where he jammed the June bug in a tire pump. Then the judge caught up and started to wail and said to Joe, justice will prevail. Then the jury met and set the bail and Joe got an hour in the city jail.
So that's the letter J. It still looks like a fish hook. You know what else we learned?
Yeah, don't drive a jet by jamming a June bug.
I've got got a minute, just a little minute. I have only got a minute, just a minute. I have only got a minute. That is all the time I have to sing this tiny little minute waltz. It isn't easy, but I'll try it then. I've got to say goodbye, but first I'll take a minute and put in it every note that Chopin wrote, and thus I'll sing the little minute waltz and hope that I can sing with no faults. And though it's difficult, I'll give it every last breath that I've got within my body. Hope that my performance won't be very shoddy. Singing every note will not do wonders for my throat. I probably will end up hoarse. Of course I will have done it, and a wager that I made I will have won. It's not the money, but the satisfaction that I get from winning money on the silly kind of bet. Though this kind of solo wasn't his intention, Chopin isn't here to make an intervention. So with your permission and no intermission, I will sing each note that that composer wrote. As you can hear, my trilling isn't very thrilling, but no one can say I wasn't very willing to attempt a thing that's not been done, and just for fun to sing the minute waltz. As I sing, the seconds fly, all too soon the minute waltzes by, and now I ask you, where am I? Halfway through the tune, and I'm falling far behind. I have less than 30 seconds, less than 30 seconds, less than 30, less than half a minute. I have less than 30 seconds, I have less than half a minute to complete this little minute waltz. Every note that's in the score, while the sands of time I know are pouring, let me win my bet and I'll run with the money down to some big store, and there I'll buy a honey of a trophy for myself to put upon the shelf to show the world I've won. Oh, the second hand is rushing round the dial, and though I'd like to end this torture with a smile, unless someone knows how to stop the clock, you're gonna see me cry before I've said goodbye. Eight little measures to complete the song, but I'm afraid my little lungs will burst before too long. If only I can last the scale, I won't have failed to sing the little minute waltz.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Six. Six, six. Six.
You remember that magic book? I just handed it back to Big Bird. Handed it. Yeah, well, that means you take your hand, you pick it up, and you give it to somebody else. I handed it to him. See, hands are very, very useful. You want to see some useful things about hands? Well, you watch.
There once was a hand. Like most hands, it had a thumb and four fingers. One, two, three, four. Which all got along quite well together. And like most hands, it was quite limber and useful. This particular hand, though, for some reason, felt especially proud of all the clever things he could do. For instance, he could wave hello. and he could wave goodbye. He could tell someone to come ahead or to stop. He could say when things were okay. And he could point to exactly what he wanted. He was also quite pleased that he could be so strong or gentle or scary, and that he could stand at attention so well. He could also scratch just about anywhere he itched. But one thing bothered the proud hand who could do so many things. He could not for the life of him make a noise. He had tried many times without success. And once, when the hand was thinking about this very thing, the little finger told the others about a way he had seen another hand make a noise. So they tried that, too. But somehow, it wasn't really what they were after. Although he knew it was silly, the hand became quite dejected. Then something happened. Only goes to show. There's really no way around it. It takes two hands to clap.
Spiders.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
7 nickels.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
7 pumpkin pies. Oh.
Raise your shoe. 3, 4, remove the door. 5, 6, rub out the brick. 7, 8, sit down and wait. 9, 10, in trouble again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Troy and Renee, I know you're sitting there and you're saying, what is Gordon doing there with that box? With the opening there, huh? And a little curtain behind it. You know, it's a game, right? Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Now, I'm going to turn it around. And I'll show you something. Behind there, absolutely nothing but a piece of cloth, right?
Yeah.
And if I were to put my hand in there, you see it comes right through.
Yeah.
Now, I'm not looking, but if something were back there, like another hand, you could touch it, and you could tell what it is because you could feel the skin, right?
Uh-huh.
Okay, now we've got a touching game. A touching game. I'm going to put something back here. I'm not going to show you what it is. And all I want you to do is when I tell you to do it, you put your hand in there, and you touch it, and you tell me what it is. You got that?
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Okay. Renee, go. You first. Put your hand in there. Tell me what it is.
A brush.
A brush. You're absolutely right. You got one right. Okay. Now don't look. Okay? Wait. Don't look. Close your eyes, in fact. I'll tell you when to open them. Okay, Troy. Okay, both of you can open your eyes. Troy, put your hand in there and tell me what you touch. Don't look. Just touch.
Nothing.
Nothing? Come on, something's in there. Come on, try again.
Okay.
Come on. Just touch. No, come down, down. Put your hand down, down. What's that?
Ice.
Ice, that was good. Okay, this is an easy game. Huh? I got your hand wet. That's what happens when you touch ice. Did you know that? It also got cold, dude. Right? Oh, got another one. Close your eyes, both of you. Okay. Renee, we're ready. Put your hand in.
Soap.
Good. Getting them right. You know, this is an easy game that you can actually take home and play. Just make a box, you know, like that. Put a hole in it. Tack a cloth in behind it and have somebody sit there. Okay. Ready?
Yeah.
Troy, come on. There's another one. Oops. Don't look. Don't look at it. Just touch. Tell me what it is.
Balloon.
A balloon? Is it a special kind of balloon? Does it have air in it?
Yeah.
Anything else in it?
Water,
that was good. That was very good. Hey, you're really doing well, Troy. Okay, ready? Close your eyes. Here comes another one. Okay, Renee, your turn. What is it?
Sand.
You got that one right very quickly. That was sand. Got all over your fingers, right? You want to touch the sand, Troy?
Yeah.
Yeah, come on, real quick. Get yourself one touch in. Sam. Okay. I got another one. Okay. See what I'll do. Don't look. No fair looking, right?
Mm-hmm.
We'll put this back up here. Now, the sand is back here this time. The sand is back here, but there's something in the sand. Now, I want you to tell me what it is. Troy, it's your turn, right? Okay. Come on. What is it?
Marbles?
You got that right. That was good. Okay, you got some more sand on your fingers. You want to touch the marbles, Renee? Go ahead. See how it feels?
Yeah.
You didn't have to look. Yak! It's not yak. Good marbles.
It's all over you.
You play marbles? Either of you?
Yeah, I play marbles.
You do? Do you, Troy?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I play with the marble head.
You play with a marble head.
Yeah, it's a game.
Oh, that's a game. I see. Okay, now don't look, because here comes the last one. Whose turn is it?
Mine.
Yours, okay.
I won't tell her.
You won't tell her?
No.
You already know? Okay, don't tell her. Renee, go ahead, put your finger in, or hand in. Don't look. What is
it?
Hair. No, it's not hair. Don't look. What's it feel like? It really feels like hair, huh?
Feels like cotton candy.
Like cotton candy. That's not bad. Okay, no, Troy, you already know, right? You must have looked. Okay, tell you what, I'm going to take it out. I'm going to take it out and show you. See what it is? It's a hat.
So, oh, yeah, that feels like cotton candy on the outside.
Well, it's not a cotton candy hat. You wouldn't want to have a cotton candy hat because everybody in your block would walk around and eat your hat, right?
Otherwise, it'd stick on your fingers.
Yeah, this feels kind of furry, you know? No, it feels furry. It feels like windy.
Who's peeking out from under a stairway, calling a name that's lighter than air?
That's me.
Who's bending down to give me a rainbow? Everyone knows it's windy.
Hey, kid, here's your rainbow.
Yeah, thanks.
Nothing.
Who's tripping down the streets of the city, ooh, smiling at everybody she sees?
Hello.
Who's reaching out to capture a moment?
Gotcha.
Everyone knows it's windy.
Hey, kid, tell them about my eyes.
And Wendy has stormy eyes that flash at the sound of lies.
How about my wings?
And Wendy has wings to fly above the clouds.
That's right, up there.
Above the clouds.
Yeah, my wings are beautiful. Hey, kid, now tell me the truth, okay?
Uh-huh.
Who's tripping down the streets of the city?
Oh, you are.
Smiling at everybody she sees.
That's you all over.
Who's reaching out to capture a moment?
Oh, everyone knows it's you, Wendy.
Uh-huh. Stand clear. Here I go. Zoom.
Wow. Look at her go. Look out. Wendy has stormy eyes that flash at the sound of lies.
Oh, boy.
And Wendy had wings to fly,
wow,
above the clouds.
Oh, no, I ain't going up there again.
Above the clouds.
Not me. Oh, my back.
Wendy?
Yeah?
You okay?
Oh, I don't know.
Oh.
Grow and go, roll over the road where the goat explodes all the O's and the crow flies low. Past the croaking toad and the boat floats over the ocean, but the wind did blow and it started to snow. So the toad went home to the telephone. He spoke to the goat who was eating a bowl of bones, potatoes and soap. A rope did float and hook the goat, and the boy climbed the stone made of O's. The O's turned to smoke and started to float closer to the bulldozer, who closed up the hole so the cold wind could not blow, and the sun did show so the roses could grow, and the whole world would know that the boat bulldozer, the toad and the crow, the boy and the rope, riding the goat, were all okay. Okay?
We would like to show you a film on the unsung beauty of manhole covers.
We're going to play a rhyming game, and it's going to be fun. Now, I'm going to give you a hint, because the last word has to be a word that rhymes with the member of the family, okay?
Hey,
you ready?
Excuse me, but I want to play this game.
Oscar wants to play the game?
Why not?
Oh, well, I was playing it with the kids at...
Well, why don't you play a game with me once in a while?
Okay, well, you can play, but you answer it too, okay?
No, I'll do the guessing. You'll just do the rhymes.
All right, here's the first rhyme now. It's not my father, and it's not my mother. I'm his sister, and he's my...
I know. Great-uncle.
Great-uncle?
Yeah.
Great-uncle doesn't rhyme. No. It has to rhyme with mother.
Wait a minute. It's not my father, it's not my mother, I'm his sister, and he's my something or other. Yeah, yeah.
Well, something or other rhymes, but it has to be a member of the family, Oscar. Now think again, it has to rhyme with mother.
Yeah. Okay, Carruther.
Carruther? Carruther rhymes with mother, all right, but...
Yeah, and it's a member of my family, Cousin Corona Grouch.
I see. Okay.
Yeah, I won that one.
Yeah, but that wasn't exactly what I had in mind. I had in mind the word brother, but I have to admit, Carruther rhymes, and he's a member of your family. Okay, kids, yeah. You want to try another one? That's good, Oscar.
Oh,
let's try another one, kids. The next rhyme, let's see. The answer to this one should not be a bother. I'm his daughter, and he's my...
I'll do that one. Yeah, I'll do that one. Uncle Grover. That's
Aunt
Zelda's first husband and fourth cousin twice removed.
Uncle Grover... No, Oscar.
That's not the right answer.
The answer is father. Rhymes with bother. Father.
Well, all right. You think you're so smart. Aren't you trying to do one of my rhymes? Huh?
All right.
Do one?
All right.
See if
let's hear one of yours.
All right. Remember now, the answer is a member of the family, and it has to rhyme.
Right.
Mm-hmm. I like this game like having a blister, if it were up to me.
If it were up to me? I like this game like having a blister, if it were up to me. Only thing I can think of the rhymes of blister is sister, but that doesn't make any sense, Oscar.
You give up?
I give up.
You lose! The answer was sister.
I like this game like having a blister if it were up to me, sister.
It's a family member, right?
Right.
And it rhymes, right?
Yes.
Who said anywhere that it had
all right,
to
Oscar,
make sense?
All right. You win, Oscar. You win. Uh-huh. Now, if you like guessing games like that one, you'll like this.
Time once again to play everybody's favorite quiz game, Can You Guess? First, let me introduce our three guests, all of whom claim to be the mother of this family. Number one, who are you?
I am the mother of this family.
Number two, who are you?
I am the mother of this family.
Number three, who are you?
I am the mother of this family.
Only one of these people is really the mother of this family. And now, here he is, the genial master of ceremonies of Can You Guess? Big Bob!
Thank you! And now it's time for our game, Can You Guess? And let's have a warm hand for our contestant, Mr. Billy Monster. Come on out, Mr. Monster.
Thank you.
Well, Mr. Monster, I'm sure you know how our game is played.
Yeah.
You have to guess which one of these three people is the mother, this family.
Yeah.
And you do that by asking them questions.
Yeah.
Go ahead, ask your first question now.
Yeah. Now?
Now.
The mother.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, number one.
Number one.
Do you comb your children's fur?
Do I comb my children's fur?
Yeah.
I work all day, and I drive a truck. No, I do not comb my children's fur.
Ah, I see. Number two.
Number two.
I said that.
Mm-hmm.
Do you keep the cave neat and clean for your family?
Cave? We don't live in a cave. Why, we live in a house. I make the beds and I do the laundry and many other things. But a cave? Why, I've never even been in a cave.
Oh, boy, this is hard.
Certainly is.
Number three. Do you teach your children how to growl and roar?
Growl and roar? I play ball. I play tag. I'm learning how to ride a bike.
Well, I'm sorry, Mr. Monster, but your time is up. Now you have to give us your decision. Which one of these three people is the mother of the family? Number one, or number two, or number three? Can you guess?
Oh, boy, that's rough. One, two, no.
Your time is almost up, Mr. Monster.
Hint.
What is your answer, Mr. Monster?
Number one.
You say number one.
Yeah.
All right. Will the real mother of this family stand up, please?
Oh, number one. Oh!
Oh, I'm sorry, Mr. Monster. You're wrong. The real mother was number two.
Well, how was I to know?
Well, frankly, Mr. Monster, frankly, I'm surprised you couldn't tell just by looking at her and listening to her voice.
Oh, come on, Billy. It's time to go home.
Oh, yeah, hi, Mother. Okay, Mommy, let's go.
Mother?
Hi, wife.
Well, thank you for playing. Can you guess our time is up? So bye-bye for today.
Ever wonder where it came from? Do you ever wonder where it comes from before the carton? Milk is made in the body of the cow. Most of the milk we drink is made by cows.
I see you now.
cow makes milk for her baby, the calf.
Underneath shady trees and sunny skies, chewing the grass so green, making the milk. Chewing the grass so green, making the
cow makes milk for her baby, the calf, but she makes much more milk than her calf can drink. So twice a day, on farms all over America, in the morning and in the evening, is milking time. Twice a day, on farms all over America, in the morning and in the evening, is milking time.
Hey cow, I see you now.
Some cows are milked by machine.
Making the milk. Waiting for milking time. Waiting for giving time.
In a big dairy, many cows are milked at the same time. The dairy takes all the milk and puts it into cartons. The cartons go into boxes, and the boxes are sent out to markets and grocery stores. Did you ever think how so many cartons coming into so many stores means so many cows?
Hey cow, I see you now.
The cow gives milk, cartons and cartons of milk. Most of the milk we drink comes from cows.
And then back to the field so green. Back to the shady trees and sunny sky. Chewing the grass so green. Making the
she is a nice, warm, friendly animal, the cow.
Hey cow, I see you now.
Do 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 do, sunny day, sweeping the clock. Hey, Ernie.
Hey, Bert.
Hey, Aaron, what do you got in the box there, huh?
This, Bert?
Yeah?
This is my ice cube collection.
Your what?
My ice cube collection. I bet you didn't even know I collected ice cubes, did you, Bert?
I didn't know anybody collected ice cubes.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I started yesterday. I gathered up all these really beautiful ice cubes, and I put them in this box. And then I put the box under the electric blanket.
The ice cubes? Mm-hmm. Underneath that electric blanket?
Oh, I had to, Bert. Those little fellows were freezing cold. But I kept them toasty warm all night. Hey, you want to see them?
Oh, Ernie, I'd love to.
Behold. Oh, no. Bert.
What?
Oh, no. My ice cubes.
Yeah?
They're gone. Oh, Bert.
Well, of course they are, Ernie.
Oh, but why, Bert? Why? I was so kind to them. Why did my ice cubes run away from home, Bert?
Oh, Ernie, now that's silly. Ice cubes can't run away from home.
You're right.
Right.
They didn't even have suitcases or bus fares. Something must have happened to them.
True.
Bert!
What?
I think I suddenly realized that I know what happened.
Well, about time, too.
Yes, somebody stole my ice cubes.
Oh, brother.
Somebody around here is a dirty ice cube thief. And when I find out who, he will pay for this.
Yeah.
I'll look for clues.
Yeah, you do that. Good idea. Why don't you look at the box real careful-like,
Look at the box.
Maybe you'll figure out what really happened to the ice cubes.
Bert!
What?
Bert, look at this. I've found a clue. Take a look in the box here. Look in the box.
Yeah?
This box used to contain ice cubes.
Yeah?
But now it's full of water.
So it is.
Mm-hmm.
Now do you see what happened?
I certainly do.
Well, good.
Everything is perfectly clear.
At last.
A fish stole my ice cubes.
Why?
Some dirty fish sneaked under the electric blanket and stole my ice cubes.
I don't believe this.
That's what happened.
Ernie, don't you know what really happens when you take ice cubes out of the refrigerator? They melt.
The ice cubes melted?
That's right. They turned to water.
You mean the water in there used to be my ice cubes, and then they melted, and that is the water that my ice cubes used to be?
That's right. Now, do you still think that a fish stole your ice cubes?
Oh, no, of course not. That's a silly thought. No, I don't think that anymore.
Good boy. Now, tell me what really happened.
Some fish melted my ice cubes. Some dirty fish sneaked in here and melted my ice cubes. And when I catch that fish, I'm going to tear him fin from fin. Oh, wait till I get hold of him.
Go get him, Ernie.
Arr, rabbit.
Arr.
Can you name this letter? If you said R, you were correct. Let's say R together now. Ready? R! Fine. Now, here's something that starts with the letter R. Do you know what this is? Here, let me help you to guess. Yes, it's a radio. That's a nice tune. My ship has sails that are...
Six letters call the alphabet. You got to learn them before you can read, write, or spell. You might become a teacher, we can never, never tell. Learn such a word, and sir, I hit so much for that. They go like this. Come on now.
ABC, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, Z.
pout. Don't pout, you better watch out. Learn your ABCs a little better. You got to know every letter.
A, B, C, D,
yeah.
E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P.
I'd not replace your sunny, funny face. Mm-hmm. Funny face. Mm-hmm. Funny face. You're not exotic, but so hypnotic. You're much too much. If you can cook the way you look, I'd swim the ocean wide just to have you by my side. Oh, you're no queen of Sheba, for worlds I'd not replace your sunny, funny face.
Hey, do you like those funny faces? Yeah? You like, basketball? Yeah? You like Sesame Street? Good. Okay, come back.
Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letters J, O, and R, and by the numbers 6 and 7. Maybe a monster was written and illustrated by Martha Alexander. It was published by the Dial Press, copyright 1968. Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop.
This is NET, the Public Television Network.